Hello, this is Mario again. This is going to be a short video about basic dependency injection on Node.js, which I'll show you with a REST APA I'm working on. To give you some context, this APA is going to have guest users, and I need to assign a unique name to each one of them. For that, I've created a sequence entity. It doesn't have an API of its own because it's consumed by the interactor that creates guest users instead. It's very simple, it only has one method, getNext, that when it's given the name of a sequence, it's going to return the next number of it. Name can be any string. And I made two repositories for it, one memory-based and another for the Node's Mongo driver. And I have a parallel file pointing to the current default repository, which is the Mongo one. Everything seems to be fine until now, but probably you've already realized that there is a little problem here. Our interactor is pointing directly to the MongoDB implementation of our repository, which is a red flag on clean architecture, because business logic should not depend directly on any particular infrastructure detail. Imagine that we wanted to run an automated test on this interactor. It's going to be difficult to test something other than the Mongo repository, because we can't switch them without changing our source code. So, let's remediate that. The interactor depends on our repository, and there's nothing we can do about it. But what we can do is make the dependency dynamic instead of the hard-coded one that we're seeing here. And it's very simple. There are several ways to do it. Some of them involve using libraries. The one I'm going to show you uses just plain Node. As you can see here, this module is returning an object with the method that we're interested in. What we're going to do is changing it, so it will return a function that it's going to build that object for us instead. Let me show you. Now, this method is going to take the repository as a parameter, and we can finally get rid of the hard-coded require. And finally, this module is going to export that function, instead of the object that we were exporting at the beginning. And now the interactor is free to work with whatever repository is provided as this parameter. Now, the require is going to return a function instead of the object, so we need to call this function whenever we need this object. Here, I'm going to use the virl file to return an interactor built with the default repository that we saw before. And you can see that the solver keeps working as it did before, but now we got rid of that hard-coded dependency. So, I hope this is useful for you, thanks for watching, and see you on the next video.